In this video, we're going to talk about chemical dosing systems, what they are, how they work, which industries they apply to, and how they apply to odour control. G'day, Bay, how are you?
Very well, thank you.
I understand you're the man when it comes to chemical dosing systems. Firstly, what are they and how do they work?
Chemical dosing is pretty much a process of delivering a chemical to a system to reduce undesirable attributes or properties of the system. Usually where we're involved is reducing odour in sewer systems.
Okay, cool. And when you talk about a system, we're talking about liquids here as opposed to gases or air.
Typically, we can reduce the odours in the liquid state so that they don't become airborne contaminants.
Let's talk about some of the situations you might actually use a chemical dosing system in.
Sure. The most common application that we work with chemical dosings in is wastewater and sewage systems. Mm-hmm. Typically that's in the network itself, where people are living in that network and they're affected by the odours. So we can be engaged by councils and water authorities to install a chemical dosing system to reduce the odours in the network. And that has flow-on effects throughout the network, usually all the way to the treatment plant.
I think what you're talking about here is the wastewater that comes out of, for example, toilets and bathrooms in people's houses, I'm assuming businesses as well. At what point during that process does your chemical dosing stuff kind of come into play?
Chemical dosing is usually comes into play once the waste is collected in a well and is then pumped out to another receiving point.
Okay.
Once the wastewater is inside that pipe, it can tend to go septic after it runs out of oxygen.
Right.
Chemical dosing can come into play where we can inject a chemical into that system and that can neutralise the odours within that pipe so that when it's discharged, it doesn't present much of a problem with odours.
Right, okay, at the sewerage plant or wherever it's going to go to.
Wherever it's receiving point, so it may be another series of pump stations or it may be at a treatment plant.
Okay, and what sort of chemicals are we talking about?
Our most popular chemical is ferrous chloride. It's popular because we've got quite a lot of ferrous chloride. It's a byproduct of steel manufacturing in Australia.
Okay.
So we can actually utilise that waste product as our main odour neutralising chemical. That's typically the most common one. And there are lots of other chemicals depending on the requirements of that system which we also use. We also use magnesium hydroxide, which is known as MHL, and calcium nitrate as well to a lesser extent.
All right, well, I don't know what any of that means, but it sounds very good. I'm sure the people listening are going to make, that's going to make sense to them. Which industries in particular are chemical dosing systems used on?
The biggest market that we work in is wastewater, which we've spoken about earlier.
Yep.
There are other types of industries which we work in, but by far wastewater is the most common.
What are some of the more interesting, quirky examples you've run into over the years?
All of them are pretty interesting, usually working in a sewer environment. They're not the types of places that most people want to be around.
Yeah.
But it's a part of life. Everybody basically produces some form of waste in some way or another. And it typically goes into a collection system, and that's where chemical dosing comes into play.
We're talking about a chemical dosing process for odour control. This is an odd one, but what sort of parts per million are we talking about? Can you give me some of the maths behind this?
Sure. Hydrogen sulfide is the main odorous gas that is usually common in wastewater systems.
Right, that's that rotten egg smell.
That's the rotten egg smell.
Yep.
Unfortunately, our sense of smell is very, very sensitive, and it can detect odors in parts per billion. So we're extremely sensitive to hydrogen sulfide.
Okay.
Again, unfortunately, because of the conditions within sewer systems, you can generate many milligrams per litre of dissolved sulfides or dissolved hydrogen sulfide. Fortunately, chemical dosing using ferrous chloride is very effective at reducing odours at the source, and we can reduce many milligrams per litre of dissolved sulfide down to less than one. I've seen first-hand examples of less than one occasionally causing odours, but typically once you get above one, you get some quite severe odours, and I've seen them upwards of 5 to 10 milligrams per litre.
All right, so 5 to 10.
Which doesn't sound like much, but it's quite a lot.
And you really know about it at that point.
You definitely know about it.
All right, good.
Once you get into those levels, you're also looking at more than odour problems. You're also looking at corrosion and damage to your infrastructure.
One thing I want to talk about, when the parts per million goes up, you were saying to, a couple of 5, 10 mils per litre, you start having these uncomfortable toxic side effects, corrosion and so forth. How does chemical dosing, what are those situations to start with? How bad can they get, and how does chemical dosing help there?
That's right, they can get quite bad. The beauty of chemical dosing is that we're actually removing the contaminants in the liquid form, so that when it does potentially can become airborne, we're actually locking that odour into the solution. A much undersold property of chemical dosing is that it does reduce corrosion within the network. Many operators will know the effect of hydrogen sulfide in their systems by reducing the steel and the concrete within their systems. Chemical dosing can actually, by locking those sulfides in the solution, mitigate any corrosion to that system. So quite often it can extend the infrastructure life.
Yeah, so it makes everything that you've got last longer because it's not corroding from the inside out.
That's right.
That makes a lot of sense.
That's right. So although there may be a cost up front, you might be saving a lot in the long term.
That makes a lot of sense. All right, well, thank you so much.
No problem.
For those of you who'd like to find out more, please visit us online at bulbeckenviro.com.au. Please, by all means, send us an email, give us a call. We'd be more than delighted to answer your questions and help as much as we can.